and clothes to shoes and computers, the start of a new school year can set your family back hundreds of dollars.
$700 to be exact. That's how much the National Retail Federation estimates you'll spend this time of year. So this morning, we sent our Christina Lori to find ways to cut those costs for us. Good morning, Christina.
Good morning, Josh and Leah. If you're hoping to save money, and let's be honest, who isn't this time of year? We are here to help. We have some simple money saving strategies that anyone can use. And here to talk about that is our financial advisor, Mark Farnan. Thanks so much for sticking around.
Absolutely.
So we're in front of a table of a bunch of school supplies. We have more pencils than we can possibly imagine.
Yes.
Buying in bulk is one of your strategies. Why is that?
It is. Well, families can go together when they have students in the same school or, you know, students in the neighborhood and buy in bulk and save money, because when you buy in bulk, you can actually reduce the cost per item that a student's going to use. So I think it's a very good idea.
And it's helpful if you have multiple kids, but also you can go with friends.
Absolutely. Like I say, families in the neighborhood or relatives, perhaps, if they're also nearby. Excellent idea to do that. And you can go to certain stores and buy in bulk and get some very good prices.
And so Madison area students don't start until next month. And if you're like me, you like to get stuff done right away. But that's not always the best strategy either. Why is that?
That's correct, because sometimes after school starts, the prices on the school supplies goes down because the big rush to get them has already occurred. So maybe get some of the supplies that you need just for the first week or two, and then the second or third week, go back to the store and get those things that are being cleared out and on sale.
And you can look in those periodicals that surface both online and in the mail?
Yes, in both places.
And really quick, we're almost out of time, but what would be your main piece of advice for anyone looking to do their back-to-school shopping soon?
I think it's a great opportunity to role model with your children about how to spend money and how not to overspend. So it's a good opportunity to be a good role model and talk to your children about, well, these are the things we need. Let's get the things we need, but let's watch the cost as well. And let's see if maybe there's some things from last year we can still use. Something got put in a drawer or in a closet that hasn't been used. Maybe there's some things you won't have to buy this year.
Go shopping in your own home. I love that. Thank you so much for talking to us this morning. And we have some more money-saving strategies up on our website, channel3000.com. You can use that as a resource when you head to the store yourself. But for now, I'll send it back to you, Josh and Leah.
Christina Lori, always helping us stay organized here on The Morning Shift. Christina, thank you.